Just wanted to do a review on the Infinity Basslink. It's raining today and I'm in the garage, the man garage, but I wanted to go ahead and get this done while I had some time. Now, the Infinity Basslink came very well packaged in a small compact box with plenty of styrofoam. Got it from Pep Boys. Very compact package. Very well thought out packaging, actually, because it came with a bunch of wires. It came with mounts so you can mount this thing a couple different ways. I'll show you the unit here in a second. It also came with a base control remote, which I haven't hooked up yet. Didn't come with any instructions, but I looked it up online. As you can see here from the box cover, there are several different outputs. You've got your RCA inputs, you've got some ground remote and battery cable. It came with the connectors for that too, so you could crimp it or however you wanted to do that. It's also got a 20 amp fuse on the system. You can see here on the system that it's got bass boost control, crossover control, as well as gain control. And this is a very small speaker system for your vehicle. It's got lots of writing on this the box, so you could read about in a couple of different languages. It's actually got a 10-inch woofer and as well as a 10-inch passive radiator. So on the bottom of the unit, it's actually got like a radiator, and I think that helps get a little bit more bass on it. Now you can mount this thing either laying down or standing up. And the reason why I like this is because you can get maximize the space if you've got a small space, and I'll show you the back of my car here in a second. It's only got about 200 watt Class D amplifier, but it seems more than adequate for it. So let's go take a look at the back of the car here. All right, so we're here in the back of my car here, 90 4Runner. So we're talking about the third generation 4Runner. And you can see that why I had to get this Basslink is because I needed to remove my box, which was 2 10-inch, and replace it with a smaller Basslink system, which fits nice and neatly in the back of the vehicle. Not hard to hook up at all. You just got your standard connections, your RCA, as well as your battery power, your ground, and your remote. And then that's it. I've got it sitting there sideways. Let's go ahead and turn this on so you can sort of hear it, possibly through this camera, what it sounds like.
Give me some!
There you have it. That was the Infinity Basslink servo controlled power subwoofer with the polymer enclosure, and by Infinity, 200 watts RMS, frequency response 200 to 120 hertz. I do believe they're coming out with the Basslink 2, so this thing might be outdated by the time you get it. I did hear some reviews that these go out after about a year or so, but that remains to be seen with this one. Again, if you're looking to retain some bass in a compact enclosure, like a small chunk of a car, or in my situation, you might want to look at some Infinity Basslink 1 or 2 systems.